So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 9th to 11th of December 2022. Alright. So yeah, without any delay, let's begin with the session. But yes, before we begin, some people were asking for November revision session. So guys, don't worry. अभी थोड़ी सी तबीयत नासाज है, गला खराब है, कोल्ड हो रखा है एंड वो वीडियो यू नो बहुत लंबी होती है. सो आई प्रॉमिस यू कि मैं वो करा दूंगा, बट यू हैव टू वेट फॉर अ वाइल. ऑलराइट, सो आज की बात कर लेते हैं. एंड यस, द पार्लियामेंट सेशन हैज बीन स्टार्टेड एज यू ऑल नो. सो अब से अब जब तक पार्लियामेंट सेशन चलेगा, क्वेश्चंस का नंबर बहुत सारा होगा. इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस 24 क्वेश्चंस. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हिच इज अबाउट पीएम स्वनिधि. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम, ठीक है. Ministry, very very important scheme and very very important question as well. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri, has extended the PM Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi, which in short is PM Swanidhi scheme, till December 2024. So now the scheme has been extended till December 2024. What is the maximum amount of third loan introduced under it in addition to first and second loans of up to 10,000 and up to 20,000 respectively? Right, so first the news is that the PM Swanidhi scheme has been extended beyond March 2022 till December 2024. December 2024, and ये पहले भी हम पढ़ चुके हैं एक बार कि इसको December 2024 तक के लिए extend कर दिया गया है. This is nothing new. The new provision which has been added is that the introduction of third loan of up to rupees 50,000 in addition to the first and second loan of up to 10,000 and up to 20,000 respectively. इससे पहले क्या होता था, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल पीएम स्वनिधि के अंदर, लेट से देर इज अ पर्सन एक्स हु हैज टेकन अ लोन, राइट, एंड इन द फर्स्ट लोन द प्रोविजन ऑफ फर्स्ट लोन इज अप टू रुपीज 10,000 ओनली. सो लेट से दिस एक्स पर्सन हैज बोरोड रुपीज 10,000 अंडर पीएम स्वनिधि, एंड इफ दिस पर्सन टाइमली रीपेज हिज लोन, देन ही इज एलिजिबल फॉर द सेकेंड लोन which is up to rupees 20,000, ठीक है. And before the introduction of this provision, 20,000 was the maximum loan that could be taken, right? And that also in the second time. अब क्या होगा, on the timely repayment of this rupees 20,000, this person X will be eligible to have the loan of up to rupees 50,000. All right. So now three loans can be taken in a period of 3 years, right? And talking about this scheme, so this scheme was launched in the year 2020, and the basic objective is to provide the working capital to the street vendors, all right, and to extend Swanidhi Se Samriddhi, right? Swanidhi Se Samriddhi kya hai? This is a component of Swanidhi program. So Swanidhi Se Samriddhi mein what government is doing, that government is connecting all the beneficiaries of PM Swanidhi program to the social security benefit schemes of the government of India, right? And now this Swanidhi Se Samriddhi component has been extended for all the beneficiaries across the country. Pehle kuch selected states mein tha ye, but now it has been extended across the country. All right. So that is all, and let's come back to the question. So what is the amount of third loan? So that's rupees 50,000. Loan of up to rupees 50,000 can be taken now on the timely repayment of first and second loan respectively. All right. So let's talk about question number 2 then, which is about rooftop solar program. And again, it is nothing new. ठीक है, कोई नया program नहीं है. Rooftop solar program phase 1 was launched in 2015 and phase 2 was launched in 2019. Right. So it is not a new program. We are discussing it about it because a reply has been submitted regarding this program in the parliament. And उसमें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बात जो बताई गई है वो ये है दैट द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर आरके सिंह, राजकुमार सिंह, दिस मिनिस्ट्री हैज एक्सटेंडेड द रूफटॉप सोलर प्रोग्राम टिल 31st मार्च ऑफ 2026. अर्लियर द टारगेट्स वर टू बी अचीव्ड बाय द ईयर 2022, बट नाउ इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड, द टारगेट ईयर has been extended till 31st March 2026, and till this date the subsidies will be provided under this scheme. Now subsidies, what type of subsidies are being provided under this scheme? So let's talk about the scheme, then you will understand the meaning of subsidy here. So guys, remember the objective of this scheme is to promote grid connected solar rooftop solar plants. वो उसके नाम से ही क्लियर है, रूफटॉप सोलर प्रोग्राम, विच मीन्स द गवर्नमेंट इंटेंड्स, द गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स टू मेक अवेयर द पब्लिक सो दैट दे कैन, सो दैट दे इंस्टॉल रूफटॉप सोलर प्लांट्स अपनी छत के ऊपर, ठीक है. And this is being implemented in all the consumer segments which are residential, institutional, social, government, commercial. And to install the rooftop solar plants, the government provides subsidies. Government क्या करती है? Subsidy provide करती है ताकि अगर मैं कोई rooftop solar plant लगवाना चाहता हूँ तो मेरा जो खर्चा है वो थोड़ा सा कम हो जाए. Alright. Its phase 1 was launched in the year 2015. The phase 2 was launched in 2019. And as I told you, the targets initially, the target year was 2022, but it has been extended till 31st March 2026. It is being implemented by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, and the overall target is 38,000 megawatt rooftop solar capacity, out of which 4,000 megawatt will be created in residential sector only. So the total target is 38,000 megawatt, and out of this 38,000 megawatt, 4,000 megawatt will be created in residential sector. And somewhere, कहीं कहीं आपको ऐसा मिल जाएगा that this is 40,000 megawatt, but in the official document of this scheme, it is mentioned at 38,000 megawatt. All right. So you can rely on this number. Now under this scheme, as I told you, central financial assistance, or you can call it subsidy, is being provided to the residential consumers so that they can install the rooftop solar plants in their houses, right? And the subsidy under this program has been fixed, right? Subsidy fixed hai, and this can be asked in your exam. The amount of subsidy is fixed at ₹14,588 per kilowatt, right? Per kilowatt, and this subsidy will be given for the capacity up to 3 kilowatt only, right? The subsidy, if let's say for example, I'm going to install a 5 kilowatt rooftop solar plant मेरी छत के ऊपर, राइट. सो आई विल गेट सब्सिडी हाउ मच, 14,588 इंटू 3, ठीक है. मेरे को 3 किलोवाट तक ही सब्सिडी देगी सरकार, उसके बाद नहीं देगी, उसके बाद का खर्चा मेरा होगा, राइट. एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सिडी इज ऑल्सो फिक्स, दैट इज 14,588 पर किलोवाट. ऑलराइट. नेशनल पोर्टल, नाउ देयर इज अ पोर्टल फॉर इफेक्टिव इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द स्कीम एंड ऑल दिस पोर्टल. A consumer who is willing to install the rooftop solar can apply and track the complete process. मतलब मैंने apply करा subsidy के लिए, मैं वहाँ पर track भी कर सकता हूँ और सारी चीजें वहाँ से information मिल सकती है. So apply and track complete process starting from registration to release of subsidy directly into the bank account. All right. So that is all about this scheme, guys. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement regarding the scheme. Its phase 1 was launched in 2015 while phase 2 was launched in 2020. Is that so? No. The phase 2 was launched in the year 2019 and not 2020. It is being implemented by Ministry of Power. No. And the subsidy under the program has been fixed at ₹14,588 per kilowatt. This is correct, which means option C, only 3 guys, will be the correct answer. Alright, moving ahead to question number 3. In which state Ministry of Tribal Affairs headed by Arjun Munda has organized free one day mega health campaign, which is Abua Bugin Hodmo, which in English is our better health, हमारा बेहतर स्वास्थ्य in Hindi. ये local language में है, Abua Bugin Hodmo, ठीक है. To offer improved healthcare services to the tribal people, tribal people के लिए को better health service provide करने के लिए this campaign or this camp has been launched or has been organized by Ministry of Tribal Affairs in Jharkhand. Where it was organized? One second. It was organized in Jharkhand. ठीक है, Ministry of Tribal Affairs ने इसको launch किया था, and the objective of this camp was to offer improved healthcare services to the tribal people. Now, what type of improved healthcare services are these? So basically, the overall objective, the major objective of this camp was to reduce the burden of 3 categories of diseases. Right? The major objective was what? To reduce the burden of 3 categories of diseases that seriously impair the health of the tribal people. Right? Now, what are these 3 categories of diseases? यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग भाई ये तीन कैटेगरीज ऑफ डिजीजेस क्या है. सो दीज आर द थ्री कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट कैटेगरी में वी हैव टीबी, लेप्रसी, एचआईवी, हेपेटाइटिस एंड अदर कंटेजियस डिजीजेस. सेकेंड कैटेगरी में वी हैव ब्रेस्ट एंड यूट्रीन कैंसर, सिकल सेल डिजीज, हार्ट डिजीज, स्किन कंडीशंस, नर्वस सिस्टम डिसऑर्डर्स एंड डेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स. एंड इन थर्ड कैटेगरी वी हैव मैल न्यूट्रिशन एंड एडोलेसेंट हेल्थ, देन वी हैव मेटर्नल एंड चाइल्ड हेल्थ न्यूट्रिशन. सो डू यू थिंक कि आपको ये सब याद करना है? नो, यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर ऑल दिस. दिस इज जस्ट फॉर द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट विच आर दीज थ्री कैटेगरीज ऑफ डिजीजेस जिसका बर्डन रिड्यूस किया जाएगा फ्रॉम द ट्राइबल पीपल के शोल्डर्स, राइट. एंड इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स इन कोलेबोरेशन विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष, टाटा स्टील फाउंडेशन एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. ऑलराइट, आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज वेयर? इन झारखंड. ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सॉरी, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर पे आ जाते. वे वॉज द 9th एडिशन ऑफ वर्ल्ड आयुर्वेदा कांग्रेस, राइट. इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. हेल्ड विद द फोकल थीम आयुर्वेदा फॉर वन हेल्थ टू शोकेस द एफिकेसी एंड स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द आयुष सिस्टम ऑफ मेडिसिन एट द ग्लोबल लेवल. सो रिमेंबर गाइज, इट टुक प्लेस एट पंजी इन गोवा. It took place at Panji in Goa, the 9th edition of World Ayurveda Congress. And of course, the objective is to showcase the efficacy and strength of the Ayush sector and to discuss how we can develop this sector more. Alright. The objective is to provide a global platform for all the stakeholders for networking and engaging in intellectual exchange. So basically, maine aapko bataya to discuss how we can develop the Ayush sector. In simple words, that was the objective. Right. And the focal theme was Ayurveda for One Health. And every year, World Ayurveda Congress is organized by World Ayurveda Foundation only. Right? Kaun organize karata hai? World Ayurveda Foundation. Theek hai? And during the event, yes, this is important. During this World Ayurveda Congress, an MOU was signed between All India Institute of Ayurveda, right, which is Indian organization, and Rosenberg's Europe Academy of Ayurveda, which is a German organization. Okay? Now, the objective of this MOU was to facilitate advanced studies in traditional Indian medicine system, which is Ayush, Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha, and Homeopathy. Right? And remember, the first WAC, World Ayurveda Congress, took place in Kochi, in Kerala, way back in the year 2002. 2002 में पहला एडिशन ऑफ WAC हुआ था, वर्ल्ड आयुर्वेदा कांग्रेस हुआ था. सो दैट इज ऑल. एंड दिस ईयर इट टुक प्लेस इन पंजी, विच इज इन गोवा. ऑफ कोर्स ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टील हैज सिलेक्टेड 67 एप्लीकेशंस फ्रॉम 30 कंपनीज अंडर PLI स्कीम फॉर स्पेशलिटी स्किल स्टील. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस स्पेशलिटी स्टील, बाय द वे? So remember guys, specialty steel is a, you know, value added steel. Now what values are added in it? So basically it undergoes through various processes, like uske upar painting ho jati hai, like uske upar greasing ho jati hai, it undergoes through heat treatment, right? And this type of specialty steel is used in strategic sector like defense, space, right? Is tarike ke strategic sector mein ye use hota hai. Now, how much financial outlay was approved for this scheme for a period of 5 years? Now, it is in news because of this reason only that Ministry of Steel has selected this much number of applications. Now, you don't have to remember how many applications have been accepted. That is not at all required. You just have to understand the basics of this scheme, which are these. Remember, the scheme was launched in the year 2021. And of course, the objective is to promote the manufacturing of specialty steel in the country by providing production linked incentive, right? And the total financial outlay for this is 6,322 crores for a period of 5 years. All right, I hope this is also clear. So the correct answer is option B, 6,322 crores. All right, let's talk about question number 6. Very important. Ministry of Railways, headed by Ashwini Vaishnav, has launched One Station One Product scheme with the objectives to promote vocal for local vision of the central government. The pilot of this scheme was started in this year only in the month of March, and presently 535 stations are covered with 572 OSOP outlets. Which of the following product categories have been included under this scheme? So let's try to understand this scheme. What is this scheme? And then we will come back to the question. So one station, one product. As the name says, one product will be promoted at one station, right? Like it is on the lines of one district, one product scheme. What is one district, one product? In one district, one product will be promoted, is being promoted. And similarly, in this scheme, under this scheme, one product is being promoted or will be promoted in future across all the station. Matlab, ek station pe ek hi product isme promote kiya jayega, jo bhi local product hoga wahan ka. Alright, so the Ministry of Railways has launched one station, one product scheme in Indian Railways. The objective is to promote vocal for local vision of the central government and to provide a market to the local or indigenous products and to provide additional income source to the local artisans, local handicraft people, etc. And under this scheme, what will happen? Each railway station will be a promotional hub and showcase destination for a local product, and definitely it will give a boost to that product. Alright. Launch year 2022 hai, and under it, OSOP outlets at railway stations are allotted for showcasing, selling and giving high visibility to the indigenous or local products. And of course, the allotment under this scheme is being done on a rotation basis. ठीक है, जैसे मान लो अब of course क्या होगा कि हम यहाँ पे उनको जगह दे रहे हैं, दो मान लेते हैं दो सेलर्स हैं, ठीक है, अब दोनों या लेट्स से तीन सेलर्स हैं या चार सेलर्स हैं, ए बी सी छह सेलर्स हैं, तो इन सारे सेलर्स को जगह नहीं दी जा सकती रेलवे स्टेशन के ऊपर. So how they will be given the spaces on a rotation basis. All right. And these are the product categories which will be promoted. The products only from these four categories will be promoted under this scheme, which are handicrafts or artifacts, artifacts, textile and handlooms, traditional garments, local agricultural produce, processed, semi-processed foods. Right. And the question was also regarding this only. So handicrafts or artifacts, textile and handlooms, railway artifacts are not there, traditional garments and this. 1, 2, 4 and 5 is the correct answer, option D. Option D, 1, 2, 4 and 5 is the correct answer. I hope this is clear. Let's talk about question number 7 then. When was the Mission Organic Value Chain Development for Northeastern Region launched by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare for promotion of organic farming in all the northeastern states? So for northeastern state, for promotion of organic farming in the northeastern states, we have this scheme. While for other states, we have another scheme. Can you name that scheme? Yes, it is Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Right? Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. So let's talk about it. And question number 8 is also there on PKVY. So we are going to talk about this scheme, MOVCDNER. And the overall objective, the major objective of this scheme is to promote organic farming in the country. Now, how organic farming will be promoted? Organic farming will be promoted by providing certification to the organic products, number one, by providing efficient supply chain system to the farmers of northeastern region, number two, by providing post-harvest mein jo loss ho jate hai, usko reduce karne ke liye infrastructure dene देने के बाद प्रमोट होगा, राइट, और यू कैन से बाय प्रोवाइडिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर विच कैन रिड्यूस द पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट लॉसेस, राइट, एंड अदर देन दिस टू सपोर्ट क्रिएशन ऑफ फैसिलिटीज फॉर कलेक्शन, एग्रीगेशन, प्रोसेसिंग, मार्केटिंग एंड ब्रांड बिल्डिंग इनिशिएट. सो बेसिकली एवरीथिंग रिगार्डिंग ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग विल बी प्रमोटेड अंडर दिस स्कीम. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2015 एज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम एंड एज अ सब मिशन अंडर नेशनल मिशन फॉर सस्टेनेबल एग्रीकल्चर. Right now, what is the central sector scheme under which the entire funding is provided by the central government? Central government, right? Talking more about this scheme, so remember guys, it is being implemented in all the northeastern states, in all the 8 northeastern states, and the financial assistance worth ₹46,575 per hectare for 3 years is provided, right? Amount yaad rakhna important hai. 46,575 per hectare for 3 years is provided for these objectives, for creation of FPOs, for supporting of organic inputs, for quality seeds, planting material and training, and for hand holding and certification. All right. And other than this, financial assistance, need-based financial assistance is also provided up to a maximum of 6 crore for integrated processing unit to reduce again the post-harvest losses. Rupees 37.50 lakh for integrated pack house. Sorry. Rupees 18.75 lakh each for refrigerated vehicle and cold storage components. Rupees 10 lakh for collection, aggregation, grading and custom hiring center. Custom hiring centers are those from where equipments can be taken on rent, right? And rupees 6 lakh for four-wheeler or transportation, right? ये वाले जो है सबसे लास्ट में याद करना, अगर हो जाते हैं तो वेरी गुड, अदरवाइज देर इज नो इश्यू. ऑलराइट, सो गाइज दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द स्कीम एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इन ऑल, क्वेश्चन इज कब इसको लॉन्च किया गया था. तो इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2015. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, आई थिंक देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम विद इट. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज अबाउट परंपरागत कृषि विकास योजना. सो आई हैव डिस्कस दिस स्कीम इन डिटेल. You can search for Anuj Jindal Government Schemes. Anuj Jindal Government Scheme, search karo YouTube pe, you will get a playlist. In that playlist, I have discussed the scheme in detail. And to the enrolled students, aap logon ke paas PDF mein scheme bahut zyada detail mein padhi hui hai. Ab ek ye isme choti si nayi information jo ki abhi PIB release mein aayi hai, usko maine question ke form mein yahan pe le liya hai. Right, I have taken this new information in the form of a question here. Right. So, how much financial assistance is being provided to farmers per hectare for 3 years? Now, you must be wondering that the answer should be 31,000. No, but the answer is 50,000 per hectare for a period of 3 years. Out of this 50,000, rupees 31,000 per hectare for 3 years is provided in the form of direct benefit transfer to the bank accounts of the farmers. Alright, so there is a difference. Total amount, total financial assistance is 50,000 per hectare for a period of 3 years. But out of this 50,000 per hectare for a period of 3 years, 31,000 per hectare is provided in the form of DBT. Okay. So therefore, the correct answer is option B. And guys, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join this Telegram channel, anujindal.in. The link is provided in the description. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, this is my ID on both Telegram and Instagram. You can ask anything here, but only the examination related questions. And yes, the live classes are going on. So if you want to ace the examination this year, do enroll in the course and join the live classes, right? And now let's do the questions, jo ki short mein hum cover kar sakte hain. The questions which do not need the detailed explanation. So where was northern regions first Divya Kala Shakti witnessing ability in disability organized by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar in collaboration with Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay, National Institute for Person with Physical Disabilities. Sari information aapke paas question mein already hai. Jo ek information nahi hai, that has been asked in the question. All right. And the correct answer is New Delhi. It took place in New Delhi. Option C. Where was the new campus of National Academy of Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institute, RUDSET, inaugurated recently? Ek naya campus aaya hai iska market mein and it has been inaugurated in Bangalore. Option C again is the correct answer. When was the Pradhan Mantri Grameen Digital Sakshartha Abhiyan, which in short is PMG Disha, and the objective of this scheme is to create the financial literacy, especially among those who are underserved and unserved. Alright. Launched under Digital India Mission to bridge the digital divide, especially targeting rural population. Right. So it was launched in the year 2017. Once again, the correct answer is option C. Now PMG Disha, I have provided guys in the detail. So I am not taking this scheme into the detail. Agar yes, phir bhi aap aise koi log aise hai jinko PMG Disha ke baare mein kuch bhi nahi pata hai and they want to study it from me only, then you can write down in the comment section. I will cover it in the next session. Right? Question 13. Which ministry had launched the Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan in 2016 with the name to provide free of cost, assured comprehensive and quality antenatal care on the 9th day of every month universally to all pregnant women in their second or third trimesters of pregnancy? Now, I am taking such questions to make you aware. Like, for example, this question and this question. I am taking such questions to make you aware that these schemes are coming in news, so that you guys prepare these schemes as well. And these schemes I have already PDF mein provide kara chuka hun. And YouTube pe bhi ye sari ki sari schemes padi hai in the playlist. Alright. So that is why I am not repeating this scheme. Okay. But yes, again, agar koi bhi scheme aapko padhni hai, to aap comment mein likhke bata sakte ho. I will include that scheme in the next section or uske baad wale session mein. So this scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. As we all know, option B is the correct answer. Question number 14. The ceiling price of medicines are specified in the first schedule of drug prices, Control Order 2013. All manufacturers of these medicines have to sell their products within the ceiling price. So the question is, which organization in the country fixes the ceiling price of these medicines under the Drug Prices Control Order of 2013? Very important question. It can be asked in your exam. It is National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, which works under the Department of Pharmaceuticals. And of course, Department of Pharmaceutical works under the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, headed by Mansukh Mandavia. Alright, so option B is the correct answer, NPPA. Let's move ahead. I am sorry, guys. मेरा गला थोड़ा खराब है तो बार बार कफिंग हो रही है. सो प्लीज ट्राई टू इग्नोर दैट. प्रोडक्ट्स इंक्लूडिंग एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोडक्ट्स विद एक्सपोर्ट पोटेंशियल फ्रॉम हाउ मेनी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड बाय डीजीएफटी, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री अंडर डिस्ट्रिक्ट एड्स एक्सपोर्ट हब इनिशिएटिव. सो आई होप यू ऑल गाइज रिमेंबर दिस. आई हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस इनिशिएटिव वन और टू क्लास बिफोर, राइट? सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मेनी प्रोडक्ट्स आर देयर. So, how many districts? 733 districts are there. Option C is the correct answer. How many waterways have been declared as national waterways under the National Waterways Act of 2016 to promote inland water transport in the country? Now, it was again in the news because the reply submitted by the ministry. And till date, 111 waterways have been declared as the national waterways. So option B is the correct answer. By which year the government has set an ambitious target to operationalize 1000 Udaan routes? Of course, Udaan is Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagarik. Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagarik, which is also known as Regional Connectivity Scheme. And to revive or develop 100 unserved and underserved airports, heliports, water aerodromes under RCS Udaan. Kab tak ka target hai? So the target has to be achieved by the year 2024. Option C is the correct answer. Aage chalte hai, question number 18 pe. This is an important question. The average annual water availability of any region or country is largely dependent upon hydrometeorological and geological factors. However, water availability per person is dependent on population of a country. The question is, the water stressed condition arises when the annual per capita water availability is less than how much cubic meters? Question ye hai ki water ko hum stressed condition, jab water ki jo stressed condition hai wo kab arise hogi? Jab annual per capita water availability is less than 1700 cubic meters. Option E is the correct answer. So, when there is less than 1700 cubic meter annual per capita water availability, then it is known as water stressed condition. Now, there is also another condition, which is water scarcity condition, which arises when there is less than 1000 cubic meters of annual per capita water availability. So, do remember this number as well. Okay? Let's move ahead to question number 19. Which agency has been set up by the Government of India for promotion, regulation and control of efficient use of water irrigation, industrial and domestic sector. So you just have to tell the name of this organization, and that's Bureau of Water Use Efficiency. Option D is the correct answer. And again, it is in news because reply, parliament submitted. ठीक है ना, बार बार मैं repeat नहीं करूंगा. Amrut was launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs in 2015 in selected 500 cities, and now we have Amrut 2, as you all know. Amrut second edition भी आ चुका है अब तो. The question is, how many projects have been completed under Amrut, not Amrut 2.0. Amrut के अंदर कितने project complete हो चुके हैं till December 2022, ठीक है? Out of the total, this much projects worth this much crores undertaken by the states or UTs. So how many projects have been approved? 5873. How many have been completed till December 2022? 4676. Option B is the correct answer. Which portal has been developed by Forest Survey of India to provide user-friendly interactive viewing of the forest fire-related data for continuous monitoring and tracking of large forest fires in near real-time basis? So again, you just have to tell the name of the portal. With respect to portal, you just have to remember 2-3 things. Which organization has developed or implementing it, right? What is the objective and the name? And yes, launch year bhi agar aapko yaad ho jaye, toh that's very good. In this question, the correct answer is 1. Agni Geo Portal. Option B is the correct answer. Which portal has been launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, headed by Bhupendra Yadav, to facilitate automation, streamlining and effective management of processes related to plantations and other forestry works taken up under CAMPA fund, which is Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority, right? Which is a fund which has been created to reduce the deforestation, right? Now, this portal is e-Greenwatch portal. Option D is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 23 then. Which ministry has launched Satat initiative, right? Har baar jab bhi parliament ka session hota hai, Satat ke baare mein ek answer jarur aata hai. To is baar bhi aaya hai, to is baar bhi padh lete. Sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation, which is Satat. It was launched in 2018 with an objective of setting up of 5,000 compressed biogas plants for production of 15 million metric ton per annum of CBG by the year 2023-24. तो इस स्कीम के बारे में आपको इतना ही पढ़ना है. What is the name Satat? What is the full form? Sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation. What is the launch year? 2018. Which ministry is implementing it? Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, right? What is the target? Target is 5,000 CBG compressed biogas plants. And what is the production target? 15 million metric tons of CBG by the year 2023-24. That's it. इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की आपको ज़रूरत नहीं है. Option A is the correct answer. And the last question for today. Which ministry has launched a centrally sponsored scheme for setting up of fast track special codes in October 2019 for setting up of 1023 fast track special codes for expeditious trial and disposal of cases related to rape and protection and POXO Act in pursuance to the Criminal Law Amendment Act of 2018. So basically you have to tell, or of course is scheme ke bare mein detail mein janne ki zarurat hi nahi hai, theek hai? It is being implemented by Ministry of Law and Justice, headed up by Mr. Kiran Rijiju. Alright. So that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.